Of the 40 players playing on the Wayne State College women's rugby team, only one girl ever even touched a rugby ball before joining the team. As rookies, they knew nothing about the game.
You would think that we'd all be varsity athletes in high school and just stud athletes, but we're not. So you have people who've never played sports before in their life.
It's actually a good thing, in my opinion. It brings out the best character of the players. You have to work harder.
The toughness attracted me to the game.
Jesse Gatzmeier, called the scrum half, is kind of like the quarterback.
Usually quick, good hands, small.
Big mouth.
Big mouth, loud. That's me.
She was about 95 pounds, heart of a lion. You absolutely cannot take that girl down.
And popular? When Wayne State takes the field, almost 1,000 people line the hillside.
Wayne State, yeah!
Today they're playing a strong team from the University of Nebraska Lincoln. Game time unleashes one of the roughest sports played anywhere.
As we say, no helmets, no pads, just guts.
We're a tough team, and so if you come play on our field, expect to go out a little bruised and a little sore.
Gatzmeier feeds the ball into the scrum, legs tangle, pushing the ball out to runners on the edges. Hopefully, the ball makes its way into a runner's hands. The whole time Gatzmeier barks out orders, she is the team's captain and inspiration. Wayne leads 14-0 when a Nebraska player limps away and the ref slaps Gatzmeier with a red card. That's the harshest penalty possible, unnecessary roughness. The team leader gets thrown off the field. At halftime, players realize they are short one player for the entire second half.
Play this game with your heart out. Don't do as I do. I got a red card.
This hurts more than any tackle. Losing to their home state rival would be bad enough.
Keep your heads up.
But they could blow the chance to return to the championships.
Not make it to Westerns would be devastating. So we have quite the tradition going.
Rugby is not a sanctioned sport at Wayne State College. No money comes from the athletic department. Players pay their own way or raise whatever funds needed to keep the team on the field. They mow the grass and they paint the lines of the field. At homecoming, they greeted football fans at every stadium entrance, hawking rugby tickets.
Come to the rugby game after the football game.
This is going to be a hard game. Hard.
At the center of the passion is their coach, Darren Barner. He played Wayne State football, discovered rugby after graduating, and brought it back to his hometown.
Is there any questions?
His unrelenting recruiting attracts athletes bored by less intense sports and girls that other teams turned away.
There was a career fair and coach just grabbed me and said, "Hey, you look like you could be a rugby player."
In high school, I played golf for 4 years, you know, and so I wasn't expected to play rugby. My parents were pretty shocked.
For a newcomer, rugby is a tough sport to understand. It's easiest to compare to American football.
Instead of the quarterback pitching to one running back, you're going to have a quarterback pitching to like 7 or 8 running backs.
This. It was very confusing. People were like, do this, do that. Like, why? Why do you just dive on the ground? Why do you have to let go of the ball? Once I went to my first game, it was like, oh, that's why.
On the team, the word family is heard often and sincerely, and it's backed up by ink on skin. The tattoos translate from Korean to rugby sisters.
The chances of us scoring the second half are probably pretty slim. That does not mean we cannot win the game.
With Jesse Gatzmeier ejected from the game, it's like a football team playing without a quarterback.
Look how many people are out here for us! They came here to see Wayne State, not the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Their football team's good, but we got their rugby team!
To play on a national stage this year, the women of Wayne had to hold Nebraska at bay for 40 very long minutes and with pure defense. In the second half, each time Nebraska controlled the ball in the scrum early on, Wayne managed to hook the ball to their players out on the fringe. There's no blocking in rugby. It's all hard tackling. And Nebraska Ruggers were brought down anytime they started making progress.
You feel it, that's for sure. But I don't know, somewhat, if when they tackle you and it hurts you, you just want to get back up and be like, okay, I can do this, and, you know, go back out there 10 times stronger.
Injuries change the course of a game, but players wear their bruises like blue ribbons at the county fair.
I have had a concussion.
I've had a concussion before, too.
A concussion and strained ribs.
Bruised ribs. Dislocated my elbow.
My elbow's chipped. I rolled my ankle pretty bad. I sprained my ankle pretty bad earlier this year.
My ankles are really bad now.
4 knee surgeries now. I'm twisted my knees a couple times.
I dislocated my hips once.
Torn meniscus.
All my ribs were strained.
I broke my nose.
To win, a rugby team needs to get the ball over the goal line, just like modern football. In the second half, Wayne State scored 2 more goals, even with their captain on the sidelines. Nebraska would never make a point. This was the second win of the season for the Wayne State women, and the dream of heading to the national level competition was still very much alive.
You're out here because you want to, and you want to play, so you're going to put your heart into it, and you're going to play till the end, till you can't play anymore.